I just created a video for you, and it's do-it-yourself, and these tips could help you with searing pain that you get across your back or even down your leg from sciatica. My name is Dr. Paul Groulx, a chiropractor right here in Ottawa on Merivale Road. So let's go. I'll show you these DIY tips for low back and leg pain from sciatica. So the sciatic nerve is the largest nerve in the body, and that's the one that travels from your lower back. It comes out from underneath some pretty big muscles in your glutes and then travels down the back of your legs and at the knee, at the back of your thigh. At the knee, it splits into two. The one branch will go down the front of your leg to the top of your foot. The other branch will come down the back of your leg to behind the ankle. And in either case, if the sciatic nerve is being irritated, it can be incredibly painful. Electrical pains, searing pains. And so this is a technique, it's called flossing the sciatic nerve. And so one of the first steps is to, so go ahead and bring your leg up like this, grab a hold of it with your leg, okay? And now what you do is you extend this leg carefully, and you can reach underneath it with your hands, and don't point that just yet, or don't extend that just yet. You can just bring your leg out like this. Now this might be enough for it to really start getting some of those electrical pains down into your toes. So if that's the case, let's say right around here, that's enough right here to start creating some pains. To start flossing that nerve now is Beth will sit up tall, okay? And then what she'll do is she'll start to bend her head forward. So just flex your chin. So if there's enough tension in that spinal cord, that alone can be enough to create some of the tension in that sciatic nerve. Now bring your head back and extend it backwards. And that'll put some ease into the spinal cord. So that is, now what we're doing is we're flossing the spinal cord and the nerve. Now bring the chin down again. And right around here in some people, that might make you jump. If that's the case, that's as far as you're gonna go. So now you repeat this by extending your head back and bringing your chin down. And right now, just with a head movement, that's enough to create movement in the spinal cord and the nerve. So the next step, as that starts to free up, is to bring your leg into full extension like this. Notice, and I'm hoping the video has got this, yeah, it does. Notice that her foot or toes are pointed. And having the toe pointed takes some of the tension actually out of the spinal cord and on that sciatic nerve. So another step you can add with her head in a neutral position is just to bring the toe up and bring the toe down. Bring the toe up and bring the toe down. Now that's a little easier to see how that can put tension on the spinal cord, but this would be your next progression, the toe up and down. So now this time, if you want to add the next progression, because you want to involve the entire spinal cord, and you can have somebody rest, you can rest your leg on a chair or on somebody's knee like I'm doing right now, is as the toe goes up towards the head can extend backwards. So this is allowing the maximal ease into the spinal cord. So are you ready? Mm-hmm. So now as I bring the toe up, you're gonna bring your head back. So we're together, where this is full flossing now down. As you bring the chin down, the toes go down. Chin up. The toes go up. I want you to repeat this, starting with the simplest version of this. You can do this 10, up to 10 or 15 times. Do it a couple of times today, but this is one of those things you want to do to tolerance.
Hey, if you found this video helpful, give the video a thumbs up. You can leave a comment or a question. More importantly, click on that red button, subscribe to my channel, because I'm always creating content to help you be healthier, live a better life, stay out of pain. See ya.